It's not, oh, you don't want to do, okay.
No, no, it's probably.
Okay, I'd like to add a personnel item to the agenda.
Okay.
And need unanimous consent.
It's got a motion, it's been properly second to add that item, personnel item. All in favor of that motion signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? That motion carries. Chair entertain a motion.
You need a motion to go into executive session?
No, no, let me adopt the agenda first. Let me adopt the agenda.
Move we approve the agenda as amended.
I got a motion to approve the agenda as amended. All in favor of that motion, it's been properly second. Any discussion? All in favor of that motion signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? That motion carries. Mr. Pierce.
Well, item one is the personnel.
Yeah, yeah, we'll go with that.
Mr. Chairman, I move that we direct the, I guess it would be the HR director.
Yeah.
To negotiate the hiring of candidate number one.
Yeah.
That was previously interviewed for the position of interim administrator.
Second.
All right. Got a motion. It's been properly second. Discussion. Mr. Malinowski.
You said it.
Well, just for the public to understand where we are, with the retiring of our administrator at the end of this month, we are hiring an interim administrator to sort of do a stopgap until we actually find a permanent administrator. So we've had interviews today, and we are actually making a recommendation for one of those candidates. That's what this motion is about. All right, so the motion on the table is for approval of candidate number one. All in favor of that motion signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? That motion carries. All right, next we have public hearing. An ordinance authorizing the issuance and sale of not to exceed $20,650,000 of general obligation bonds series 2016A or such other appropriated series designation of Richland County, South Carolina, fixing the form and details of the bonds, delegating to the county administrator certain authority related to the bonds, providing for the payments of the bonds and the disposition of the proceeds thereof and other matters related thereto. That public hearing is open.
Did we provide a sign-up sheet?
Okay. Is there anyone in the audience that would like to speak on that item? Okay. Not hearing none. That public hearing is now closed. Item 2B. We've got a public hearing on an ordinance authorizing the issuance and sale of not to exceed $15,500,000 Broad River Sewer System General Obligation Refunding Bond Series 2016B or such other appropriated series designation of Richland County, South Carolina, fixing the form and details of the bonds, delegating the county administrator to certain.
Thank you.
Found one.
All right. Delegating the county administrator certain authority related to the bonds, providing for payment of the bonds and disposition of the proceeds thereof and other matters related thereto. That public hearing is open. Is there anyone in the audience that would like to speak on that item? Not hearing any. That public hearing is now closed.
That was the second agenda.
Yeah, I got you. All right, next we have third reading items. Item 3A, a fiscal year 2016-17 budget ordinance. All right, you have your, Mr. McDonald?
Yes, sir.
You want to say anything to start off?
Yes, sir, Mr. Chairman. At this point, we will direct the council to the motions list. You should have it in front of you. It has been emailed out. There have been a few changes. We've tried to keep it up to date whenever we've gotten additional or new information. So hopefully you've got the latest version in front of you with the date at the top right of June the 9th. And assuming everybody has that, just for orientation's sake, Mr. Chairman and members of council, the items on the motions list that are highlighted in yellow are the ones that we believe, we being staff, believe that you need to address individually because something has either changed in those situations, or there may be new information that we did not have on second reading, or it could be in addition to the motions list. So the items in yellow, again, are the ones that we feel that you must vote on individually because of those changes. The items in white, on the other hand, which is obviously the majority on the list, include the items that have not changed or nothing is different from the second reading vote. So if you want to, we think that you can vote for the items in white as a block. You don't have to pull them out separately. You, of course, can do that if you want to revisit any issue. But if you want to not vote on those individually at all, or just do it as one block for the entire motions list, we believe that you can do that, again, as long as we take each of the yellow highlighted items individually.
Okay.
Mr. Chairman.
Chairman. Mr. Pierce.
I think Mr. Jeter had his arm up first.
Okay, Mr. Jeter.
Just real quick, so looking at this list, now we've given second reading, and now we're going to third. Are there any items that you're talking about in the white where we see a significant change in the amount of either the meal value or dollar value?
No, sir, Mr. Jeter. The items in white, there should be no change at all. Everything should be exactly as it was on second reading.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. So now some of these ones in white are withdrawn. Are we voting on that they're withdrawn?
If it was withdrawn, then the same holds true tonight. Okay. It's off the agenda. We left it there just to show you that it was there and was withdrawn, but as far as we're concerned, it is not part of the budget at this point.
Okay. Mr. Pierce.
I just recommend, Mr. Chairman, that we try to vote these white ones in blocks, not as a whole.
Okay. All right. Well, we'll go through. All right. So items, we'll start with item one.
Mr. Manning.
Oh, I'm sorry. Mr. Manning.
Mr. Chairman, on page one, the two, number one and number two, which are not highlighted, as opposed to block, I would like to move that we approve on third reading item number one, and then I'd like to have a discussion about item two before we move on in blocks, please.
Okay.
So my motion is to approve on third reading item number one for school district one.
I second that, Mr. Chairman.
A motion for approval has been properly seconded. Any discussion?
Yeah. Just number one.
Yeah,
school district one.
Yeah. Passing out.
All in favor, any more discussion? Mr. Malinowski, any more discussion? All in favor of that item, signify by raising your hand.
In favor, Rose, Dixon, Jackson, Pierce, Rush, Livingston, Dickerson, Manning, Jeter.
Any opposed, like sign?
Opposed, Malinowski.
That motion carries.
Mr. Chairman, point of personal privilege.
Yes.
I'd like to thank the members of School District 1 for being here for the vote, Mr. Superintendent, and other members of the board. Thank you very much.
All right, item number two, chair entertain a motion.
Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Manning.
On item number two, and let me reference you to a few figures there prior to my making the motion, please. You see on the third column, FY16 approved, FY17 request, and then the next one's FY17 no mill, FY17 at the cap, and the cap is about just under $2 million less than what was requested. We just recently today received the mill numbers. On second reading, we had the discussion about the fact that School District 2 had hoped that when the mill numbers came out, and of course they're projections now, they're not the actual mill numbers. We get those in October, generally. Based on that, of course the district is still hopeful that when those come out and they're official, that there will be a millage increase to actually give them their requested amount of 142, 202, 732. In the meanwhile, my motion is that council go ahead and approve a look back millage, which they have available because the school board in the last couple years has not requested up to the cap. That we go ahead and we approve now on third reading the look back at whatever amount that needs to be. Well, we know the amount actually to cover that. I don't know what the mill number is, but we know the dollar number. And when the mill, the actual mills come in, if indeed they're there to cover that money, then they won't need to do the look back. But that the look back would be there as a safety net for that October figure. So my motion is that we approve the amount requested, the FY request of the district, the 142, 202, 732, by utilizing the available look back cap.
That's the motion on the table.
I'll second it for discussion.
And it's been properly seconded. Discussion, Mr. Pierce.
Mr. Driggers, look back millage is something new to us. You know, we used it last year for the first time. And I think you need to advise us about look back millage. I mean, the school districts have separate look back millage from the general fund, is that correct? Is that what I'm implying? What's being implied?
I think that's correct. What's being implied?
Well, do you know how much look back millage they have?
If I could, I'd like to defer that to the auditor's office so that they can respond to that.
I'd like to know how much they have in order to know what we're doing here.
Clarification, can you explain what this look back millage is for everyone?
It's unused millage from previous years.
Let them explain.
Excuse me.
Mr. Chair, James Hayes, Richland County Auditor's Office. I don't have the look-back millage in front of me, but I can speak to the differential between what our office has produced and what school district. If I can, I'd like to explain the differential in the $2 million. Okay. Mm-hmm. We have calculated their mill value to be $290,000. In calculating the mill value, we look at the various taxable categories, manufacturing, vehicles, including fee and loot. We do that so that we can get and just have a projection of what the mill value would be comprising all taxable categories. You know, so everything that's taxable in the county, that's how we compute the mill value. So in this case, it was $290,000. So having said that, once we have the mill value, we can apply the millage rate to that to get the tax dollars generated. So we did that and we submitted that to the school district. And looking at their calculation, they have a mill value similar to ours, ours is $290,000, theirs is $290,500. They multiplied the millage rate times that, but they double counted the fee and lieu dollars. When you're calculating the millage, when you're calculating the millage, you can include the fee in the fee and lieu assessment with the mill value, or you can include the fee and lieu dollars. There, the $290,000 has the fee and lieu assessment dollars in it. So if you count the fee and lieu dollars with it, you're double counting. Their school district 2 normally gets about $2 million in fee and lieu dollars every year, so that represents the difference. They're including the fee and lieu assessment plus the fee and lieu dollars, so that's where the difference is coming from.
All right.
I can get that.
What's your question?
The question is, how much
look back
millage is available to cover the the difference between what you're estimating and what the district is requesting.
Like I said, I can get that dollar amount to you, Mr. Pierce, but I just don't have it in front of me right now.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Pierce. You done?
Yes, sir. But I think we need clarification on that before we approve it.
All right, Mr. Livingston.
Well, I had the same question. I don't have the answer to the question as to whether or not when we're talking about look back millage, is that dollar amount that we get refers to the total county, or does it refer specifically to a school district?
I don't know.
Is the answer that I need to?
Each individual millage agency has its own look back millage. Okay, like the county, if you have not used it in 3 years, the county has their look back millage, and the school district. So it is separated by millage agency.
Do we know? So we don't know what the school district look back millage is.
If you give me a moment, I actually can go get it for you right quick.
Yeah. Okay, Mr. Chairman, I move that we defer this item until they come back with the figure.
Okay. We'll defer this item until we get this information, and we'll take it up once that information comes back to us.
Thank you,
that
Mr.
motion
Chairman.
On table is for deferral. It's been properly second. Deferral is non-debatable. All in favor of deferral, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? That motion carries. Item number three. You want me to read it, or you want to go before? The millage for the recreation department is determined.
Well, we don't have to vote.
I thought we didn't have to vote.
Well, you want to do all white?
May I address that, Mr. Chairman?
Yeah.
That was voted on and passed on second reading. The only reason it is highlighted tonight is that when you pass it for second reading, the funding source to do the audit was not identified. So we put it back on to clarify where the funds would come from. We would recommend that it come from the Recreation Commission's budget, but we want to make sure that you're good with that.
Okay.
I move we take the money out of the Recreation budget.
Second.
Okay, motion has been properly second. Any more discussion? And we're approving this item with that recommendation.
With that caveat, yes.
Any discussion? Mr. Jackson.
Okay, you moved to take it out of the budget. Did they budget for an audit?
Yes. No.
They did not.
Right. Not for this, no.
Do you know how much the audit will cost? So we're going to take out of their budget, or identify that they should take out of their budget, which they didn't plan for, to do an audit, and we're not sure how much the audit will cost. Okay.
Right.
I have a concern in doing something like that. I mean, if someone sends a budget, they send it for a specific amount. And for us to decide that, okay, we're going to tell you to do an audit, we're going to tell you to take that money out of the budget, which was not budgeted for, I see, I have concern in doing that. Thank you.
One moment. Thank you, Mr. Jackson. Mr. Malinowski.
Hey, Mr. Chair.
I got you.
It was my understanding that state law requires that this commission do an annual audit. Is that true?
They do. And we get a copy of it every year, Mr. Malinowski.
Okay, but that's just a financial audit, and we're looking for otherwise. Is that right, Mr. Pierce?
I think that I believe the motion included a financial audit and an operations audit as well.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Malinowski. Mr. Jeter.
Yes, real quick, and if I read this correctly, if we vote to support the motion, we're still going to hold 5 mils until the audit is complete, right?
Well, we're going to give them 5 mils, we're going to hold the seven mils until that's what's frozen.
All right, so going back to Mr. Jackson's comments about having a mandated sort of audit taken out of their budget, can we take it out of a portion, either the 7 mils that we're holding?
Yeah.
Why don't we make that recommendation that the funds come out of the 7 mils that we're holding, and that way it really probably wouldn't be any harm being done immediately. So as opposed to just taking it out of their budget, the 5 mils. So I'll make that as a substitute motion.
Second. Okay. That's the substitute motion. It's been properly seconded. Any more discussion? So the substitute motion is to to approve this item and take the audit funds out of their remaining mil, 7 mil.
Yes.
All in favor of that motion, signify by raising your hand.
Not sure about that.
In favor, Rose, Malinowski, Dixon, Jackson, Pierce, Rush, Livingston, Dickerson, Manning, Jeter.
Any opposed? Like sign. That motion carries. Item number we just did that, right? Do you need to do it again?
Yes, sir, Mr. Chairman. If I could speak just for a second about actually the next four items, items 4, 5, 6, and 7, the reason those are highlighted is because with the new millage numbers, the updated millage numbers from the auditor's office, there are slight changes in each of these millage agency numbers. And so in order to keep the same level of funding dollar-wise that you approved on second reading, you would need to make an adjustment either up or down on each of the four that are coming up. Now, the changes in the numbers from the auditor's office are not changes to the mill values or the millage rates themselves. It's really numbers that reflect the carryover numbers that are carry forward numbers that the millage or that the auditor's office has been updated with recently. So that's the reason for the change. So for example, with the Recreation Commission, the 13,560 that you approved on second reading with the new numbers from the auditor's office, that number, because it was a no mill increase, that number changes to 13,470,000. So slightly less than the number that you approved on second reading. So if you want to keep the 13,560 number, that would mean a slight increase, if you will, in the mill rate.
No, whoa. No.
Point of clarification, Mr. Chairman. I think.
Mr. Pierce.
Okay, we actually voted on dollars.
That's right.
We didn't vote on millage.
Yep.
Okay?
That's right.
So all you're asking us to do is decide whether we want to keep the dollars we voted
exactly.
on or vote for the millage that we voted on.
Exactly.
So I move that we approve the millage on those four items.
That's what we voted on, right?
Which is what we approved. And whatever that is adjusted to be by this reading. Wouldn't that do it?
Whoa. Click.
That'll be
listed. Okay, I'm sorry. That was a motion. That's your motion?
Yes, sir, as long as everybody understands it.
Clarify your motion.
Okay. All you're asking us to do is adjust to the millage.
That's right.
That we voted our dollars based on the millage.
Based on the millage from second reading, right. That's right.
That millage is staying the same. The dollars are just changing. So unless we want to change the millage, if we just approve the millage as adjusted, that would take care of it. And that...
I'm not understanding that.
Okay.
Can you clarify that?
I'll withdraw my motion until everybody understands. Okay.
If I could just walk through an example on the Recreation Commission.
All
I think
right.
you have two options.
Right.
Option one is that you don't change your vote. You don't do anything. It's going to approve $13.560 million. That's going to equate to a 1/10 mill increase. Option two is to say, I don't want the mill rate to go up, which means you have to make a motion to change the dollar value to 13.4 million.
Yeah, we voted on
no mill increase.
No mill increase.
Yeah,
okay. That's
but again,
right.
you have to vote on the dollars, not the rate.
But the mill would have changed, so it's the same.
So if we vote on no mill increase, then it will be the 13.4 million.
Your motion will be that you voting for $13,470 million.
Or no mill increase, is that the same? Or that's not
it's the not the same.
No, you said it's not the same.
Your motion needs to be in dollars.
Okay, that's fine.
Okay.
All right.
For clarification.
Mr.
So if at second reading in our great preparation and deliberation, we voted on a dollar amount. If we stick to that dollar amount tonight, y'all figure out whatever happens to the millage number. If we start trying to figure out the millage and play with millage tonight, God knows what might happen to the dollar amount. statement?
No.
Because there is a dollar amount over here.
Mr. Chair.
Misty, give us the dollar amount.
How can the dollar amount go down if we continue approving the dollar amount? And they adjust the millage, they do whatever they need to do with that mill number for us to keep the dollar amount, which is what we did all our discussion on.
But that could increase your mills.
That is correct.
But that could increase your mills.
It will. In this case, it will, and as Mr. Drigger said, by a tenth of a mill, it would increase if you stick with the same dollar value or amount that you used on second reading. That's correct.
And so my question from District 8, where we're not the brightest crayons in the pack, is if we want the money that we understood that we all did, then we just vote for the money and y'all change the little mill number.
That's not necessary.
That will be the effect.
Yes, that's
all right.
That would be the effect of it.
Okay.
All right. You done, Mr. Mann?
Well, no, I'd like to make a motion that we proceed with these four items that we have highlighted in yellow, that on third reading tonight, now, my motion is that we approve the dollar amount as we did on second reading, and that the staff do whatever they need to do to make the little mill number be what it needs to be for us to approve the dollar amount that we deliberated on and approved on second reading.
If you approve the dollar amount.
Approve the dollar amount.
Of that dollar amount. We voted for the cap, which was that dollar amount. If you vote the dollars now, it's going to cause them to get less money than they would if we moved the cap.
Well, let's take each one individual. Item number four. Can I chair entertain a motion on item number four?
I move that we give
as opposed to doing the block. Let's do it one by one.
One
by one.
We give the Recreation Commission a no mill increase.
Second.
Got a motion on the table.
$13,470,125.
That's the motion on the table. It's properly second. Any discussion? All in favor of that motion signify by raising your hand.
In favor, Rose, Malinowski, Dixon, Jackson, Pierce, Rush, Livingston, Dickerson, Jeter.
Huh? Any opposed? Like sign? That motion carries. Item number five.
Mr. Chairman, for example, if we were to vote the dollars on item number five, you would be voting. We had voted for the cap, thinking the cap was that number. 5.507504, but the cap is actually 5541628. So if you vote the dollars, they will get less money than the cap.
Okay. Chair entertain a motion.
And we voted for the cap.
Chair entertain a motion.
The motion is we give them the cap, Midlands Tech operating at 5,541,628.
That's the motion on the table. It's been properly seconded. Any discussion?
Mr. Chairman, I make secondary motion. I move that on items 5, 6, and 7 that we approve them at the cap with the new millage cap.
I second that.
We need to put a number in just for the record. Are you good with that?
Right here.
Okay. I just want clarity so we can make sure we're clear on it. So you don't need a number on that?
No.
Daniel. Okay. Okay, that's.
Wasn't that a cap?
Yeah. Okay, you heard the substitute motion. It's been properly seconded. Any more discussion? Mr. Jackson.
Okay, so for example, Midlands Technical College, we had passed 5,507,504. So if we go to the cap, it should be 541,628, so
it's
less than what we passed.
No,
it's
more.
It's more.
507 versus
507. Yeah, it's a 507.
Yeah. So increasing that one, okay.
Yeah. Right.
If you look at the number in the orange, it's going to tell you what the cap's going to be.
Right.
All right, Mr. Malinowski, you done? I'm sorry, Mr. Jackson, you done?
Yeah.
Mr. Malinowski.
Chair, I'm just putting my hand up to buy me some time to review these figures over here. Is there any reason we can't just do them one at a time? We'd have probably been done by now.
Well, there's a motion on the table.
We're good.
And it's been properly seconded.
Motion on the table.
Second, there
are motions
to the
cap, right? Yeah, on items 5 through 7. You done, Mr. Malinowski? All right. Any more discussion? All in favor of that item, signify by raising your hand.
In favor, Rose, Malinowski, Dixon, Jackson, Pierce, Rush, Livingston, Dickerson, Manning, Jeter.
Any opposed? Like sign? That motion carries. Are we good with the numbers now? All right. We'll take up item number 2 before we get too far. Do we know what?
Mr. Chair, I think the question was how much look-back millage that District 2 had available. Tax year 13, they left 3 meals on the table. Tax year 14, 4.8 meals. And this current year, tax year 15, 4 for a total of 11.8 meals, which would equate to about $3.4 million.
Mr.
Chairman,
let me repeat.
Just, yeah,
3 meals, 11 meals.
Tax year 14, they left 4.8 meals. Tax year 15, which is the current one, they left 4 meals. That's a grand total of 11.8 meals, right, which equate to, at the current meal value, $3,422,000.
Okay.
Okay.
That makes up the difference.
So what's the total that we're going
to? Mr. Manning.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. So my motion on item number 2, and again, go over to the third column where it references the fiscal year 16-17, 17-17, and the 142.202-732, which is about $2 million above what the current mill. So using approximately, given that 3.4, just a tad more than half of the look-back mills that still have about half of their look-back mills still available for next year and the next year and the next year, that we approve the 142.202-732 using that look back millage, which will be just a tad more than half of what they have available. And if the district's projection comes in true in October, then they won't need to use that. If it doesn't, they'll be able to use that to fund their requested budget,
which is 1,754,398.
All right, that's the motion on the table.
That's a quick question.
Second, one moment. Motion on the table is for, that's the motion on the table. It's been properly seconded. Discussion, Mr. Livingston.
Is that about, what, a three mil increase? Can one tell me what? At least an addition of 3 mils, is that? That addition equates to about 3 mils?
Again, if you were going to use to get the $2 million that they were short, that equates to about roughly 6.8 or 7 mils of the total, 11.4.
7.8.
Okay.
Is it, for clarification, is it they're short of that or that's above the mill?
No, the current? They're
because they have to do
their request is about 1.7, almost $2 million
above the
less than what we submitted as the cap. So what Mr. Pierce was suggesting that they use the look back millage.
Yes.
They do have that available. And I was saying if you were to fund it, say $2 million, that roughly is about seven meals of the 11.8.
That's in addition to what the cap is.
That's correct.
Okay.
That's right. Correct.
Mr. Livingston, you said
that's how I was getting it. I'm good.
Once look back.
All right, you done?
Yes.
Mr. Livingston? Ms. Dixon.
No.
Sorry.
I'm fine. I know who he's talking about.
How much will that equate to property tax with this millage increase?
Okay, well, I can roughly do that for you right quick.
Okay.
But for, you know, of course, homeowners, that's not going to be a cost. What I'll give you is for a 6% property.
Thank you, Mr. You done, Mr. Dixon?
How much? What was that figure? I didn't hear.
What type? No, it's only.
Hold on. Basically, $100,000.
$100,000.
No, rental property. About 42.
So $42 increase on rental properties.
Yes.
Yeah, they agree to fundamentally.
Right. No, right. Again, this is in addition. That's what I'm saying. That is in addition to. That's just the increase for look back. Now, right, exactly. So the total.
It's 42.
Plus the cap would be about $114. Because this would be a total of about 19 million. So we would increase currently from where they are 8 mils, it's about 15 mil total 15 mil increase.
Okay, that was my question.
One second. Ms. Dixon, you done? All right.
Hold on, let me revise that total.
I'm sorry.
15 mil increase would be about $90. So it'd be because the cap, the current amount is 304. Taking out the cap is 312. 8 meals. And if you add an additional 7 meals, that's a total of 15 meals. So that equates to about a $90 on a $100,000 house.
Okay, thank you.
That's a question. Total number of meals.
Chairman, for clarification.
I got you.
So the $90 is now replacing the 114.
That's correct. That's right. You know, that would be a total of a 15 meal increase.
I understand. I just want to be clear that you told us 114,
right. it's
but then you did some calculation and we're down to 90.
$90. That's
thank
correct.
You, sir.
That's correct.
Mr. Livingston, you have the floor.
I want the total meal increase. This is 15. I got what I needed.
Yeah, total 15.
All right. Any more discussion? Mr. Pierce.
Just FYI, does School District 1 have any look back millage? Or did you?
School District 1, do they have any look back millage?
Yeah, did you happen to check? Would you happen to know just yes or no?
They left 1.1 meals on the table from the current.
Hey, thank you. I just want to know what.
Not much.
All right. Any more discussion? All in favor of that motion, which includes the look back, signify by raising your hand.
In favor, Rose, Dixon, Jackson, Pierce, Dickerson, Manning.
All opposed? Like sign?
Opposed, Malinowski, Jeter. Rush, sorry.
Motion carries. We're down to items.
Chairman, as a point of personal privilege, I'd like to thank the school board members and the administration and the children of school board members that came out tonight for the budget deliberations.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Manning. Mr. McDonald, yep. Item number 8.
Yeah, Mr. Chairman, the remaining millage agencies, items 8 and 9, did not change.
One moment.
Before you go any further, I also like to acknowledge District 1, school board members.
I did that already, Ms.
I didn't hear. Where was I?
I did that. All right.
I need to wake up. Well, anyhow, I'm thanking you all as well.
Thank you.
All right.
All right, Mr. McDonald.
Yes, sir. Mr. Chairman, the remaining millage agencies, which would be the zoo, item 8 and number 9, mental health, nothing changed for those. So if you don't necessarily.
Oh, give me one moment. Let me block them. So items 8 through.
8 and 9 would complete the millage agencies, and you do not need to vote on those unless you just want to revisit them.
Which one? 8 and 9, you don't have to vote on?
8 and 9, that's correct.
You don't have to vote on those.
Okay, with second reading.
That's right.
Okay, so
nothing changed from second reading. Okay, when you vote at the end of the meeting, when you vote on the final budget ordinance, it will encompass or capture those at the same level as second reading. Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. What about 10 through 15?
10 through 15, same situation with those.
Okay. 16 through 22.
Come on, keep going. Wait a minute. I don't want to overlook the parking garage. All right. Go ahead. Go ahead.
All right, 16 through 22.
Manning's having a little fun with Mr. Pierce, okay. Folks.
16 through 22.
Yeah. The same, Mr. Chairman, would exist here. These are the special revenue funds.
Which one?
And through page six, item 41. Those are special revenue funds and enterprise fund agencies. Again, nothing changed between second reading and tonight. So if you want to if you don't want to revisit those, you don't have to vote.
Okay. So we'll just do that then, all right?
Okay.
So what about 42?
Through 41. 42, Mr. Chair, was highlighted. I believe there was some confusion as to whether or not that was actually approved on second reading. This is the Pinewood, and it's Mr. Jackson's motion. I'll let him address it. It's the Pinewood Lakes capital project funding, which is in the fund balance of the hospitality tax, but it is not appropriated, although it is tagged or designated from last year's budget approval, if I'm not mistaken. Again, I'll defer to Mr. Jackson if he'd like to discuss.
Yes, it was approved. The funds were set aside. Now this is the motion to release the funds that you have set aside to complete phase two of Pinewood Lake Park.
Are we done with phase one yet? Is phase one done?
Yeah, phase one has been completed.
So when the bathrooms are in what, phase one or two?
Phase two.
Yeah, the bathrooms are in phase two, and the council appropriated, I believe, up to $1 million out of last year's budget out of phase two to go ahead with the bathrooms, if I'm not mistaken, Mr. Chairman.
Okay. All right, any more? I get a
There's no motion.
We're in 241 first.
Oh,
right?
It's no H.
You asked about 42, but we're going.
No.
We're in 8241, aren't we?
No, 4041 is under white. Yeah. 42 is the release of your funds.
The one we're talking about is 42.
I move that we release the balance of the funds to complete phase two of Pinewood Lake Park.
That's the motion on the table.
Second.
Then properly second. Discussion. Mr. Jeter?
Yeah, and just real quick, that's item number 42, right?
Yes.
What's the dollar amount?
That's what I'm getting rid of.
If I can, so far you've approved $6.9 million in the fund balance. You've appropriated $2.4 million. You have $4.5 million in the fund balance that this would release. It would appropriate it.
Phase two.
I'm sorry.
Phase two, we're appropriating, if we support this, 4.5.
I'll let Mr. Jackson answer that. I'm not sure about the phases. I know that there's 4.5.
Hold on now. Go ahead.
Am I explaining?
I guess, yeah. He's got the money, but you're going to explain it. Go ahead.
No, we had approved and set aside $5.4 million to complete phase two. Mm-hmm. However, last year, we took $1 million out first to do the bathrooms. Mm-hmm. And there's a remainder of 4.5 left to complete phase two.
Okay.
We have set aside, that money has been set aside, everything has been approved, it's just to release the money.
Phase two is
The amphitheater, the multipurpose building, the splash pad, and the dock, completing the walking trail, things like that to complete the facility. All that has been approved already. It's just the funding is needed to be released. The funding was already approved and set aside. It's just to be released.
That's right.
All right. Okay. You got it, Mr. Jeter, you still have the floor.
I'm finished.
All right, I got Mr. Malinowski. Mr. Pierce.
Okay.
What I'm the flood did all that damage out there. What's going to what money's going to repair the damage of the walking trail and all that stuff? That
we got damaged? We got funding to repair the walking trail from FEMA. We got 43,000 plus to repair the walking trail. The spillway, right, is a different, like every other dam now, there's a spillway, and we're working with the FEMA to get some funds, or with the Conservation Commission for some funds for the spillway.
Thank you.
But
so all, so the park is back to a completed and operational phase one completed?
Got a house on it.
Everything is back to normal out there?
No.
No.
We have the money to complete phase one. I mean, the walking trail that was torn up.
I can't do that.
Yeah. Mr. Chairman, if I may. Yeah, Mr. Jackson is correct. We did receive funding from FEMA, about 45 mil.
45,000.
45,000, I'm sorry. Yeah. 45,000 from FEMA as a result of the flood and the damage that the flood did to the walking trail, and it pretty much destroyed the trail for the most part. Now, I think the estimates to completely repair that have been more than 45,000.
That's what I'm asking. Where is that money going
to
come from?
And if I'm not mistaken, they've been somewhere closer to 100,000 to do completely what is needed to be done to complete the walking trail or to restore it as it was. So there would be the question of where would that additional amount beyond the 45,000 that came from FEMA, where would that come from to complete that project? So that would be a question that would need to be answered still.
Mr. Manning?
This phase two walk, that's going to be the 360?
What's the question again?
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you. The phase two walkway is going to be the 360.
The 360.
Yeah, lake's round so that you can walk 360 degrees around like it's a new baseball stadium.
Yes, phase two would complete that. However, at the moment, the Department of Transportation got permission from the county to build a temporary bridge and a temporary road because they're removing the existing bridges on Garner's Ferry Road, replacing it. So they'll have it temporary until sometime this fall, when the new bridges are replaced, then we'll be able to complete it. So you had to get a temporary permit from DHEC for land disturbance, and the consultant and everyone is working now to coordinate all of that so we can move forward by the fall to complete it. It takes a time to get the permits.
Phase two includes the funding.
Yes.
That when we're done with the phase two funding, you'll be able to walk the whole way around the lake.
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
All right.
Make a motion. We put a total on that.
Was there a, what was the dollar figure? Did we ever say what the
4.5 million. The balance that was held. How much is the balance?
The balance that's not appropriate is 4.5.
4.5 million.
Total room.
All right.
One more question.
Yeah, I got Mr. Lipson.
Okay, after Mr. Lipson, I got one more.
Mr. Lipson.
Yeah, again, like I said, remember the funds are already set aside for this simple purpose, but my current concern is before we decide what we do with those funds, I still think we haven't resolved, in my opinion, some governance issues as it relates to the park. I also think we haven't resolved, in my opinion, some operational issues if you're talking about spending $4.5 million. You know, and I think I need more guidance from our professional staff that we pay to give us the guidance on this particular park. I don't think I have enough. My recommendation would be, so long as the money is still there, we at least defer this matter so we can quickly deal with the governance issues, operations issues, those things that we know need to be in place before we decide to spend the money on the phase. My recommendation is to defer that and get more information from and guidance from council.
Motion on table for deferral. It's been properly seconded. Deferral is non-debatable. All in favor of deferral signify by raising your hand.
In favor, Rose, Malinowski, Rush, Livingston, Dickerson.
Any opposed? Like sign.
Opposed, Dixon, Jackson, Pierce, Manning, Jeter.
Deferral is 5-5? And that motion fails. The motion on the table is for approval. Was there a motion on the table for
approval? Yes.
To release the funds.
For phase two, that was the motion.
All right. Any more discussion?
I have discussion on this.
Ms. Dixon.
And I'm in favor of doing this phase one, but I'm like Mr. Livingston on this. I really need to know the governance manner that we're gonna deal with this. I mean, really and truly, until we nail all of that stuff down, I mean, I don't know how we're gonna do it because we have not settled the first phase. Deal. We still got problems with the first phase.
What I'm trying to say,
figuring out the operational part of it and making sure that we have the right board in place to take care of the money that we're about to disperse.
Can I answer that?
You done, Ms. Dixon? Mr. Jackson?
Just to answer Ms. Dickinson's question, I think Tuesday night we agreed and voted on the contract, and the staff would develop for something to come back to us, right?
That's clarification. That's what I'm talking about, for staff to come back to us with whatever it is we need to do.
Yeah, that's what the contract part, what I'm saying.
So
that has been agreed on that already, right? What we're doing
staff
now
is... Staff hadn't brought me a thing back.
That's in the near future. What we're doing right now is approving phase two, right? It's complete phase two.
But Mr. Jackson, please understand what I'm saying. I understand we approved all of that the other night for the 150.
Okay.
I got that. The point of this is what I'm trying to say, but we said that staff is supposed to bring us back a proposal how we should actually, you know, govern those finances. So if we do this, we're gonna have to, like a board or whatever. I mean, what I'm trying to say, until the staff brings me that information back, so how we can actually operate it. Then I think we should hold it until we get that information, know how to proceed. I mean, I just need to know how to proceed with this issue.
Okay, and let me continue. This is going over 2 years now.
Oh, Jesus.
And every time we try to move forward with this park, right, we are holding back, continuing asking staff questions after questions after questions, right? We have proved everything is just to release the funds to complete the park. The park has been operating...
Management part.
The park has been operating... for over a year, and a nonprofit organization approved. We have a current contract with them to operate the park. They received no funds, and they've been operating the park. We can do is just close the park and tell the people in Low Ridge and wait until council and staff decide to move forward sometime in the future, and the park just remains there, or we can complete the project. We have spent over almost $4 million on the project. It's just there waiting, it's weathering, right? And permits has to be approved. We have to go to DHEC and get permits to move forward. And this is just to release the funds, right, to complete the park. So I can't say that the problem is that we have to wait again for staff, something new now, to come up with, which already agreed on Tuesday night, that I think it's an enterprise fund.
Yeah.
And a contract. We agree with the contract. It's just the board. And we have we decide who's voting, who is on the board to move forward, right? I don't see why we can't move forward with the construction. I'm just saying why we can't move forward with the construction of the park.
Well, staff hadn't brought me that information.
But that's for the future for them to develop.
One moment, Ms. Dixon. Are you done, Mr. Jackson?
Yeah. Well, no, I'm not done yet because what I'm saying is that every time it comes to something with Lower Richland, we have a problem.
I said
everything should be similar to historic Columbia. We have spent $5 million on Historic Columbia, right? Historic Columbia is a quarter of an acre. We spent $5 million. Palmer Lake Park is over 44 acres. We had no problems renovating one house for $5 million. We have no problem spending over $270,000 a year for operations for one house. But when it comes to Lower Richland community, you have a problem in releasing the funds that has already been approved. I'm not asking for new money. This over a year, 2 years now, I'm asking to release the funds to complete the project. And you're saying the people in Lower Richland, forget you, wait until we come up with another obstacle to move forward.
Mr. Chair.
This is not a trick question, right? This is not a game. These are people in the community who are actually using the park for safety. I had to raise hell. We had two porta-johns that these people had to use the whole time, entire time, for disrespect when it was approved in phase one, but somehow it was taken out.
because a staff member took it out. And it was important, John.
I thought they released the funds.
Oh, I'm just saying this. Initially, right, it was taken out.
Okay.
But right, these people was important for 2 years.
I'm
right?
coming to you.
So then I got, and you came back and raised to release the funds to build the restrooms. Right? They're building the restrooms now. It's under construction. Right? It's just to release the funds. The operations, you can kill the contract. In 90 days, you can take the contract. You have that power. The attorney, Mr. Smith, told you on Tuesday, you have the discretion to 90 days notice to remove the contract. So that's a safety. And I thought you all understood that on Tuesday. So I don't see where there's a problem now about a contract and having everything before we move forward. You have that right. Thank you.
Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair,
One moment.
I had a point of clarification.
Ms. Dickerson, you have the floor.
I have a point of clarification. First of all, I resent anyone telling me that I do not like the projects that's going on in Lower Richland. That's not a Lower Richland project. That is a countywide project.
But it's in Lower Richland.
I don't care where it's
located. Well, I care where that.
I don't care where
it's
located. One moment, Mr. Jackson. One moment.
The fact of the matter is that is a countywide project, and it's for everybody in Richland.
I didn't say it wasn't.
Mr. Jackson, one moment.
So don't say I'm not supporting the people in Lower Richland.
No, you're not supporting them. You never did.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Thank you. Who else? All right. The motion on this, Mr. Jeter.
Yes. Okay, let's calm down. We got it. If we move forward and support this, I mean, I guess phase two, we would still have to bid out whatever the project is. So, I mean, there are some parameters that have to take place.
You don't have to.
But we can't just randomly go out and just spend $4-something million. I mean, we're going to have to bid it out for construction.
It was a design-build contract. We approve it as a design-build contract.
What I'm saying was... I'm like, trust me, Norm, when I ask you this, I'm not.
No, just clarifying.
Yeah.
Clarification.
So if it's a design build, I mean, who's designing and who's building? I'm saying we hadn't made that selection yet.
Yeah. You want to clarify?
Yeah, who's doing it?
When we did Pinewood Lake Park, Chowan Associates, we approved Chowan Associates as a design build to build the park. They have already designed everything. They just get part of the payment in phase one. Phase two has been designed already, not the building specifically, but the trail, the amphitheater, everything has been designed. It's just to release the funds to complete it. We had a design-built contract. It's just the funding is in phases.
Okay.
But this council, you see, it takes it so long.
That's a clarification.
Not question. We took so long to approve it, we forgot what we have approved.
That's clarification. Mr. Cheater, you
all right, I just thought we... You know, if it gives somebody some comfort that we would still have to bid the project out, so there would be more information and documentation on the actual cost. But, you know, that was my thought. But
yeah. All right. Thank you. Okay. Mr. Pierce.
Okay. I did not vote for this project, but it passed. And the council had, they voted for the majority voted for it. So... We have this project, whether we individually want it or not, right? And even with Mr. Jackson's comments that I personally take offense to because he picks on something that means a lot to me, the fact of the matter is that we've got to finish this project. The sooner we finish this project, the sooner we are done with it. Otherwise, we're just going to drag it out and out and out. How long? We approved the project. It's been approved. So to me, the sooner we get it over with, we get it over with. So, you know, I'm all for, I'm not in favor of the governance as we have it right now. I think that needs to be looked at, but that doesn't, the sooner we get the project over, the better, the happier I'm gonna be, so.
Okay, you heard the motion on the table. Any more discussion?
Yeah, Mr. Chair, I wanna be clear on this, because I support the project. So I'm not arguing whether or not I support it. I'm going to vote for it. But I do want to get clarity on the construction piece, because I remember us doing phase one, but I don't remember us approving all the phases for a contract. I just don't remember that part. So I just need, at some point, I want staff to give me clarification on that.
What about now?
All right.
Huh? Do y'all have that information?
Sure. Yeah.
So did we approve the contractor for all phases?
Mr. Chairman, I don't know that I would say it quite like that. I think what you did when the phase one was approved, I think it was a design build for phase one, and I believe the total cost for phase one was about $1.4 million or somewhere in that range. I think there were some preliminary designs done as far as the remainder of the park, what I think Mr. Jackson's calling phase two or phases two and three. So I think the engineer that designed phase one did some preliminary work on the remainder as a complete project. Now, if you want to continue that route, certainly you can do that. If you want to go another route, I think that's up to the council. I think you could bid it out if you wanted to, or put it out for proposals if that were your direction. But I think you could go either way, Mr. Jeter.
Mr. Jeter, you still have the floor. I got you. Mr. Jackson.
When we did Panel Lake Park, because from your member with the history of problem purchasing the land, we had an engineer from Georgia came and said, if the dam broke, how much 100 people would drown because the flood and the water and everything, if a 100-year flood came, we had a 1,000-year flood, right? The example they used was a 400-foot dam in Georgia compared to a 12-foot dam in South Carolina, to Panel Lake Park. I was very careful. I spoke to the attorney. The motion, and you can go back and read the minutes, right, is to approve Panel Lake Park, and I think it's Mr. Malaski made the motion, go back and read the minutes, right, to prove it designed, built. We didn't have all the money at one time, so we said we'll do a phase one and a phase two. Right? The procurement director back then made some changes, and that's why we didn't have the restroom in it. They designed the entire park with the walking trails, where everything's supposed to be, and did some designs. They're just waiting on the funds to release it. We made it in phases, but we approved the design. We can't have two different architects or two different engineers, right, design built on a project we once started. We'll have to pay that person for the design they have already done, because we contracted for them to do the design built. We didn't say design build phase one and we'll bid out phase two. That didn't make sense. But that's what the motion, I can say, go back and read the minutes. That was we approved. Everything has been approved, has been clinched. It's just to release the money to complete the project. That's all there is.
Thank you, Mr. Jackson. Mr. Livingston.
Mr. McDonald, how was phase one procured as far as the architect and the design build and so forth? Because I don't remember us voting on that.
I believe you did, Mr. Livingston. When the money was appropriated, and it was approved at that point as, again, for phase one, as a design build project, and I think the council did approve that.
I'm sorry, I'm at phase two.
Oh, I don't think you voted.
Phase two, I'm sorry.
At least to my recollection, and unless I'm missing something, I don't think you've taken a vote to go forward with phase two at this point. No, now, again, the money has been identified, and the money has been designated, if you will, on the fund balance for the hospitality tax, but it has not been released. And if you don't release it, if you don't move it out of fund balance and get it into the appropriated or an appropriated budget to move forward, then there would be no moving forward with phase two.
So the motion for us tonight is just to move it out of fund balance. That's what you said.
Well, and again, I don't want to speak for Mr. Jackson. I think the motion is to release it out of the fund balance so that phase two can move forward. Yeah. And again, I don't want to speak for Mr. Jackson.
May I clarify?
Just clarification, Mr. Jackson.
Motion was to release the funds that was approved by this council to complete the project. That's the motion. Everything has been completed, voted on, and clinched.
That's clarified. I got you. Mr. Lewis, do you still have the...
So there's no changes?
Yeah, I'd like to make a substitute motion to move the money out of fund balance, but I need more instruction from council in terms before we move forward on the phase. So, but
can't do that.
But I'd be willing to remove from fund balance.
You can't do that.
What?
He can't do what he's doing.
What?
He cannot do that.
Where? Can't do what?
What he's asking to, he cannot do it.
Move it out of fund balance?
I'll second that for discussion.
But what he's adding to it, he cannot do it.
What you mean?
Let me clarify again.
Oh, no, hold on for a second, hold on a second. What was your motion?
My motion is to remove it out of fund balance so we can go ahead on and try to do something with it once we realize it, so the money will be available for us to use, but not to move forward with the phase, but get it out of fund balance so we can have the discussion about the phase okay. So we can move forward.
All right, that's been properly seconded.
Okay, discussion,
Mr. Malinowski.
Okay, go ahead.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I think this is what's important right now is we move the money out of the fund balance, we make it available for moving forward with whatever phase or project we're at that's next that goes up to this dollar amount, and that whether or not we've previously approved a design build or did not approve it, that can be revisited, but we can't do it unless we get the money out of fund balance. So let's get it out of fund balance and move forward, figure out how we're going to do it. Bid it out, design build it, whatever we had, and let's just go back and revisit that at the time. But I agree with Mr. Livingston. Yeah. Move it out of fund balance and let's be done with it.
Okay, that's the motion. Any more discussion?
Yes, discussion.
Mr. Jackson.
What does it mean to move it out of fund balance?
It means like take it out of the bank so you got it in your hands.
So you can use it.
Okay.
Easy to use, you know.
Oh, okay, you got it in your hands. What does that mean? Do they move forward with the project or you just have it in your hands?
Have it in your hand, you can still move forward. You gotta make some decisions.
So, okay, if this is approved, right?
No.
Are you telling me July 1st the contractor can continue with phase two?
No.
Okay. I still got the floor. We approved, we voted, and we clinched everything. The only thing left, and that's why I'm not going back and visit it so you can tear it apart. The only thing left was to release the funds, and that's why my motion was to release the funds. Because some were against it, some were for it, right? And 3 years later, right, some are still against it and you're trying to tear it apart. It was clinched. We voted, we clinched, we set the funds aside. And it's voting to release the funds. That's it. We can't do anything else to it because that has been clinched. And we have to honor that.
Let me ask this for clarification now.
One moment. Livingston. Malinowski.
Now, remember that the reason why I asked the administrator the question I did just now was whether or not phase two was procured. If we're not clear on whether it was procured or not, and he doesn't think so, we can't move forward anyway.
That's right.
Go back and take.
So at least we can have the money there.
That's what I said in my discussion.
You done, Mr. Livingston?
Let's confirm what was done and move forward at that point in time.
Mr. Chair.
We can't do it until somebody finds out from the minute. Period.
The substitute motion is to approve for bringing it out of fund balance,
yes.
Not moving forward. That's the substitute motion.
You can't do that.
But it's 4 pound wood
lane. Yeah. Yes.
Yeah.
All in favor of that motion, signify by raising your hand.
Rose, Malinowski, Rush, Livingston, Dickerson, Manning, Jeter.
All opposed, like sign.
Jackson Pierce.
That motion carries.
What does that mean?
All right. Now we have item 43. Mr.
Chairman,
yeah.
I'd like to change my vote because, Mr. Jackson, I don't believe you're making the right decision here, but I do want to vote with you. So
I don't know what this. I don't know what it means.
Okay, you got that.
What it means.
All right.
I don't know what it means.
All right. Item 43 was withdrawn. Item 44 through 55? Is that correct, Mr. McDonald? All those are withdrawn, so we do that at the end.
Yep. Mr. Chairman,
we go to 55A, I believe.
Yeah, you're good up through 55. If you go to 55A, it would be the next one you would need to take a vote on.
Yeah.
Okay.
Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Pierce.
Speaking with Mr. Driggers earlier in the day, he recommended that in order for us to do what we have done in terms of the individual discretionary, that we need to approve this particular item that I asked them to draft. So I'm simply sponsoring this motion on behalf of the administration. And if you have any questions, let's direct them to Mr. Driggers and Mr. McDonald.
Second.
Okay.
Second.
It's been properly seconded. Any discussion? All in favor of that motion, signify by raising your hand.
In favor, Rose, Malinowski, Dixon, Jackson, Pierce, Rush, Livingston, Dickerson, Manning, Jeter.
Opposed, like sign.
That motion carries.
Now I'd like to approve item 56.1 through item 56.1. What wrong?
Yeah, nothing's wrong. I was just going to point out if you, because of the motion you just made, because you're going to be bringing back as you identify which agencies you want to provide funding for, you would not necessarily need to vote tonight on 56.1 through 56.11.
Why?
Because
you can just allocate it.
Well, I'm sorry?
Can you just allocate it? You can just...
Yes, that's what 55A allowed you to do.
Yeah. Okay, all right.
So you can just send in your list.
Don't need to vote on that?
No. I'm going to let Mr. Driggers further clarify that.
Yeah. Yeah. Again, my brain work is simple. So there's two options. One is you have a list in front of you that's dated today as of 5 o'clock that I believe is the list everyone has sent me. If you approve 56.1 through 56.11, it approves these allocations that you have on these sheets. If you do not approve 1 through 11, all it means is you'll have to bring back your list to council for one reading after July 1. That's the alternative.
Second.
56.1 to
56.11. One moment. Okay. Let me just get clarification on that.
Why would we do that?
Explain that again, please.
55A. What 55A does is it says that we're going to set aside a pot of money, and each council member can bring back their list or an agency at any time throughout the year with one vote of council to allocate it.
Thank you.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So if you, let's say you had stuff on this list, it's approved tonight. Mm-hmm. But what if you had a balance? Can somebody come back through the year and then you can allocate some of it?
Okay. That's right. With one reading of council.
But that would need to come back to council for a vote.
That makes sense. So you got a motion on the table? It's been properly seconded. Discussion.
Clarification.
Jackson.
The motion is to move 56.1 through 56.11. Am I clear?
Yes.
Yeah. And in 56.1 through 56.11, we have sent in a list to you identifying the agencies and the projects.
Yes.
So if we approve this, those have been approved.
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
All right.
Okay. All in fit. No. Any more discussion? All in favor of that motion signify by raising your hand.
In favor, Rose, Malinowski, Dixon, Jackson, Pierce, Rush, Livingston, Dickerson, Manning.
Any opposed? Like sign?
No hand. Are you going to not get this on this?
He's for it.
Any opposed? Like sign? That motion carries. Item. We go to item 64A.
Mr. Chair, from looking at the submittals from individual council members, I was concerned about the CBV, but look like that should be taken care of, so I'll withdraw that.
Okay.
Withdrawn.
That's withdrawn.
64A.
All right, 64B.
64B, Mr. Chair, is move that we fund the Famous Lahart New Year celebration at the same rate we did last year.
Second.
Where does it come from?
From undesignated hospital tax funds like I did last year.
Okay, that's the motion on the table. It's been properly second. Discussion. Mr. Driggers, look like you got something to say. Okay, Mr. McDonald?
No, I was just asking for clarification on where it was coming from, but I believe Mr. Livingston said fund balance of the H-tax.
Of the H-tax, yes. Okay.
Is it available?
Oh, yeah.
All right. Mr. Malinowski.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. This is exactly what I thought we were trying to eliminate by dividing the funds up from the hospitality tax. Everybody agreed to that. Everybody agreed that they would put their money where they wanted to individually, and now we have one coming back saying, I want more for this particular item. No. If we do that, then we're going to be right back where we started, and everybody's going to be putting more in, wanting it for other items. So I recommend get with a couple folks that want to support this and get it to the level you want, because I can't support it based on what we are doing. Thank you.
Okay, that's the motion on the table. Jackson.
Yeah, I think this is a joint venture we decided to do with the City of Columbia. which has nothing to do with individual, but a partnership with two governments, and which is totally different. Thank you.
Any more discussion?
Yeah, I have Ms. some. And I'm going to support it, but I'm going to tell you why. I'm going to say one thing. We're going to have, I'm going to request that we have better participation in it, because last year when we jumped up with all this money, they totally ignored every council member, and we were not included. And I said this year I was not going to support it. But at this rate, since we have a thing with the city, I will. But last year they totally ignored council, and we had no input. So we give, here again, we give money, but okay, I want your money, but I don't want to see you. Thank you.
Okay, any more discussion?
Manny.
This is my best substitute motion, but I move that on what we just did a minute ago about H-Tax, that Councilman Manning's list remove the $1,500 designated to this and be put in my unspent.
Hold on.
You have the authority to do that, though, yeah.
Let me ask you a question. Is it possible that they can go back and remove or move things around?
After clinching.
On the list?
Yeah, on your list.
Mr. Chairman, and I'll let, again, Mr. Driggers address that, but that is one of the, that would have been one of the benefits of not approving 56.1 through 56.11, because that would have given you more discretion as the year, as we get into the year.
I thought we said that's what we were doing.
You approved it. You actually went ahead.
Listen. But when I ask you, during the year, all you need to do is, you approve these, but
for unallocated amounts, you bring those back. But now, since you've approved these, I think to unapprove them would take another vote of council. And again, and Mr. Driggers agrees.
No. Oh, one second. All right. What's your motion again,
my
Mr.
Motion substitute is to motion. Go back and on my list,
can you just do
where I have $1,500 for famously hard, that be removed off my list and that $1,500 be put in my undesignated money.
Let's wait
before I vote on this one.
But it may, okay, but it may not pass.
If it doesn't, then I'll make a motion to go back and put the $1,500 back in. I'm just telling you.
All right, I got you.
I was like Mr. Malinowski. When I gave them $1,500, I was not looking at whether I'd be voting for $75,000 later on.
All right, Mr. Dick. I need a second to that.
Well, no, before you
Madam,
go,
Mr. Manning.
No, I want to add to
one
Mr.
Second,
Manning.
One second. He did a substitute.
Okay,
properly second.
Let me remake my motion. My motion is Councilman Manning and Councilwoman Dickerson have their famously hot New Year's money that we previously had on that approved list be undesignated to them and put into our undesignated figure.
This point of order. Give me one second. Can we do it that way, or do we have to go back and reconsider that item?
We got to vote first.
Because these are two separate items.
Yes.
Parliament, Mr. Smith.
Item first.
We have to reconsider that.
We have to vote in the
court
item first.
It's called Ms. Smith.
Each one of you split up.
Yeah.
It sounds like maybe what Mr. Manning wants to do before you do the third reading is take a portion of that.
No, we already did a third reading on that part, though. So do we have to reconsider that part?
Okay, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Then that'll have to be reconsidered.
So that's a separate, we're going to go back to that and reconsider those items. So let's take this item first. Because we can still go back and reconsider you.
Okay.
Mr. Chairman?
I trust you.
Wait a minute.
One second. Mr. Malinowski.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
I'll come to you, Mr. Pierce.
Why don't we take the people that were willing to give this money to them
and subtract it and just approve the rest of it?
I'm okay with that one.
All right, somebody needs to make a substitute motion of what that dollar amount is.
Substitute motion.
Well, I'll make that substitute motion.
Second.
To subtract the amounts already given and just approve the balance that they
want. How much is that, right quick?
Thank you. I'm good with that.
That's
what's needed.
How much?
$67,500.
Okay.
No, not $67,000.
$6,700.
The part that they gave was $67,000.
I'm sorry.
He's on what would have to approve.
The approval amount.
Yes. What would be left to approve?
All right. All right. So the amount is $67,000. That's your amendment to your motion.
I'm good.
It's been properly seconded. All in favor of that motion, signify by raising your hand.
In favor, Dixon, Jackson, Livingston, Dickerson, Manning, Jeter.
All opposed, like sign.
Malinowski, Pierce, Rush.
That motion carries. All right, item 66.
Mr. Chairman.
One moment.
Before you go to that,
65. What's that?
All right, the motion we just carried took Mr. Manning's money and Ms. Dixon's money out.
No.
Did
no.
it also transfer
no.
that?
No, it didn't.
It just approved a dollar amount.
Yeah.
Right.
So Ms. Dixon and Mr. Manning's money is still.
Yeah, they know that.
So that doesn't change.
They know that.
So they're going to leave it in?
They're going to leave it in there.
Thanks. Okay.
All right. Now I'm a 65.
I thought they wanted their money back.
No, we don't want our money back.
One moment.
I want to be accounted for.
Okay.
Chairman, 65 you do not need to vote on.
Okay, 65. Okay, 66.
Yellow.
66 is just the hospitality tax total budget, $6.4
million. You do that at the end or what?
If you could just approve that as amended.
Right now?
Yes.
Okay.
And then got a
motion for approval. It's been properly seconded. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand.
Malinowski, Dixon, Jackson, Rush, Livingston, Dickerson, Manning, Jeter.
Any opposed, like sign?
Opposed, Pierce.
That motion carries. Item 67, can we take this in a lump?
Mr. Chairman?
I'd like
to take one of these out.
Okay, just give me a minute. Give me a minute. Let me talk to the administrator. Then you. Okay, 67 through...
Mr. Chair, unless Mr. Pierce wants to pull one out.
We will pull one, but let's just get a lump sum number.
Then you're good until you get to 88B.
Okay, so 67 through 88, all right?
And you don't need to
vote
on
which one would you like to pull out?
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to remove item 75A.
I'd like to make a substitute motion.
No, there's no motion yet.
Okay, well, I move that we go through item 74, that we do a block of the special revenue, and then we go on to 75
available.
So,
okay, that's the motion on the table. It's been properly seconded. Okay.
Do what now?
You don't even need to vote on it. Because we're going to vote.
Unless you're going to change something.
Okay. All right, so item 75A, Mr. Pierce.
All right, all I'd like to do is the recommendation was to fund the bond court using look back millage. All I'd like to do is to remove the word look back millage because there is now money in the general fund sufficient to cover that.
Okay.
Due to the local government fund. And this would
good.
That's all
second.
It is. A simple
second.
Okay, that's the motion on the table. Fine. It's been properly seconded. Any discussion? All in favor signify by raising your hand.
In favor, Rose, Dixon, Pierce, Livingston, Rush, Dickerson, Manning, Jeter.
Any opposed? That motion carries. I had to get the judge a hard time. What do we have? Item 66.
No.
No, 64. Oh, we did all those, right?
Yeah, we're good until we get to 88.
Oh, so we're good through
88.
All right, so
88B.
What's this about? Just you.
Mr. Chairman, 88B is just a procedural issue. We do this every year in the budget. What this does is reflect any changes that may occur between now and the end of the fiscal year, salary-wise, so that it would be picked up for the next fiscal year. Again, this is more of a procedural matter than a substantive matter.
Chair, entertain a motion.
Second.
Got a motion for approval. It's been properly seconded. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand.
In favor, Rose, Malinowski, Dixon, Jackson, Pierce, Livingston, Dickerson, Manning, Jeter.
Any opposed? Like sign. That motion carries. All right, 88C. Yep.
Mr. Chairman, item 88C, if you will remember from earlier this week, Tuesday night at the council meeting, we had presented information to the council about the proposed staff recommended, and I think the Health Insurance Ad Hoc Committee recommended changes to the health insurance plan, which included a dual option health insurance plan where there's a base plan and a buy-up. We have funding in the budget already incorporated into the total budget amount for that. And if everyone is in favor of moving forward with that, simply we would need simply a vote here to implement that, and we will begin that process next fiscal year.
Move approval, Mr. Chairman.
That motion for approval has been properly seconded. Any discussion? All in favor of that? Mr. Manning.
I'd like to make a substitute motion that we do some recalculation regarding the amount people pay for those employees that make over $80,000.
Say it again.
Okay, it doesn't.
My motion is that we do some recalculation, that in other words, employees who make more than $80,000 would pay a little bit more of something that would give some advantage to those that make under $80,000 in the whole scheme of things. And y'all, I don't even care if that's $20 a year. I just think that we should do something to recognize the people that make above $80,000 in a regressive system of health care ought to pay a little bit more than the people that are making under $80,000 in the county.
Okay. I think I'll second that for discussion, because I see Councilwoman Dickerson raise her hand, and I may have questions for legal as well as HR on that motion.
Okay, the motion has been properly seconded. Discussion. Mr. McDonald, you were going to say something?
Well, Mr. Chairman, I just wanted to get clarification on what I think Mr. Manning is saying. There would still be the dual option, Mr. Manning, and there would still be I guess this is a question. There would still be, under your proposal, the more standardized plan where employees, regardless of the salary, would pay zero, but to buy up to the higher level, those making $80,000 or above would pay more to buy up than those making less than $80,000. Is that what you're saying?
Yes, I think that's what he's asking.
That's good. I mean, I just, when this is all said and done, I would like for the employees to look and say, council did something to recognize that the people making over $80,000 and me making down here $28,000, that I'm not paying the same amount as them. That proportionally, there's some bit of difference. And the county council did recognize that they wanted in some way try to look out for the living
people. Okay, discussion. Ms. Dickerson.
Actually, this really doesn't affect me really much, but I want to find out why somebody's been taking $50 out of my check. I really got a point on this. If I'm going to participate in the wellness program, that means I don't pay nothing. Is that correct?
That's correct.
Like from what HR those programs that they give every year?
Yes, ma'am.
So I got to participate in them, like do the 100 steps and all that kind of stuff in order to not pay $50 a month?
Yes, ma'am, that's correct.
But if I elect not to do it, then I'm going to have to be paying $50 a month.
Yes, that's correct.
Okay, that's what
okay,
I'm
Okay, Ms. Dixon.
Then that's not fair for me. Do I need to participate in the wellness program in order not to pay $50 a month?
That's a weird look.
Yes.
I thought I'm already healthy.
There we go.
No, that's the truth, but that's not
the floor, Ms. Dixon.
I'll get with HR. That's okay.
Mr. Jackson.
Thank you. To me, salary is salary. And if somebody's making $200,000 and somebody's making $10,000, salary is salary. I'm not going to challenge and take from the one who's making $200,000 to pay any additional money. I don't think that's fair. Whatever you agree to work at, that salary, that's your choice. I can't support that. What I did, and I made a motion earlier, is to develop a class and come study and develop a process for those people on the lower scale how they could move forward in county government. You have some people working for 30 years and has been a class one or a driver one for 30 years. There's no process for them to move forward. I did that in a motion so we can develop a process to class and comp to help those folks you're talking about now. But to say, because I make a certain amount of money, I should pay more, I don't think that's fair. I think it should be across the board as it was. Mm-hmm. Everyone pay the same amount. Thank you.
Thank you. Any more discussion? All in favor of that motion, signify by raising your
hand.
No, the substitute motion. Okay. It's a substitute motion. All in favor of that motion, signify by raising your hand.
In favor, Manning.
Any opposed? Like sign.
Opposed, Rose, Malinowski, Dixon, Jackson, Pierce, Rush, Livingston, Dickerson, Jeter.
That motion fails. The original motion is for approval of this item. All in favor of that motion, signify by... You need a question?
We're raising your hands.
Yeah, all in favor, signify by raising your hand.
In favor, Rose, Malinowski, Dixon, Jackson, Pierce, Rush, Livingston, Dickerson, Jeter.
Any opposed? Like sign?
Opposed, Manning.
That motion carries. Item 88B.
Mr. Chairman.
D, I'm sorry.
Mr. Chairman, item 88D, redirect $278,161 from unspent project funds to cover startup equipment for the Decker Center. If you remember that discussion from the council meeting, also from the council meeting earlier this week, that was deferred at the council meeting Tuesday, referred to tonight's third reading of the budget. What this does is have the project budget for the Decker Center pick up just over $278,000 in capital costs that otherwise were not incorporated into the operating budget for Decker Center. And information had been distributed to the council since Tuesday, which breaks all that down for you. But we'd be happy to answer any questions if you have any.
Okay. Got a motion for approval.
Second.
And properly second. Discussion. Mr. Malinowski.
Hey, Mr. Chair. I didn't get a chance to contact staff since Tuesday night with this, but is the Sheriff's Department, that's an entirely new precinct they're putting in there?
Mr. Malinowski, I believe they're moving the existing
region to
Major Cowan. Yes.
Moving from the Columbia Mall.
That's
over
correct.
There and then several divisions of the Sheriff's Department.
Yeah, they need to go back.
That's correct.
I agree with that.
It's not a new precinct. It's not a new division.
And that's fine. I just wanted to know that. And another question I had was, I'm fine with the equipment for the new folks going out there, but I was just wondering why. I guess equipment counts radios, and then down below here it's got mobile radios again. So that's why I'm wondering. Does up above we're paying $16,000 plus for each new sheriff's employee, new sheriff's deputy, but then down below we're approving more money for mobile radios, which I kind of thought would have been part of equipment to begin with.
Mr. Malinowski, I'm going to ask Mr. Bronson if he would help you with that. I think he can answer that better than I can.
All right.
Kevin Bronson, Assistant County Administrator. Yes, sir, Mr. Malinowski. It's my understanding that most of the equipment that is listed up there, it did not include anything that is capital related. That equipment would be things like uniforms and anything that wouldn't classify as capital. The radios classify as capital, so they were moved out of that line item into the capital portion of that so it could be captured by the program funds.
Okay, and also 12 deputies, 3 supervisors. Do we normally have 1 supervisor for every 4 personnel?
Those were the Major Cowan can speak to that if he doesn't like my answer.
In speaking, clarification, I believe that would be 88E, not 88D.
Yes, but speaking okay. to the
answer that now because we're not there.
Oh, okay, but, yeah.
But I also question the fact that we're paying over $6,000 between these two groups for 8 coffee makers and 7 microwaves. I just don't believe the taxpayer should be paying for coffee makers and microwaves. Why are they in here?
Those were requested by the departments. So it, what you see listed under the Sheriff's Department.
So just because they, okay, because they requested it, it automatically went there.
When we put the budget together for the Decker Center, if the items could be pulled out as capital to be paid for by the project fund, we did. That's why you see the coffee makers and the microwaves listed, because they're small capital.
It's still tax money that's paying for it.
It's furniture.
And to pay $6,000 for coffee pots and microwaves, I think that'd be a personal choice. Maybe I don't drink coffee or use the microwave. Maybe I want a beer pump in there. They're going to do that for me? I mean, let's be realistic.
I make substitute motion that we add beer pumps. Or
one moment. That's out of order. That's out of order.
Jim Beam dispensary.
I'd make a substitute motion on this one that we approve it, less the coffee makers and microwave.
Okay, that's the motion. It dies for lack of second.
What's the motion?
The motion was to approve without the coffee maker, and it dies for lack of second.
Okay.
All right.
Mr. Chair, first of all, then we need to go in there and take this microwave out of here. We need to take that coffee pot out of there. And air the coffee pot. I don't care, but I'm gonna beat this dead horse, okay? My point is,
you missed all.
Well, they in there. We paid for them. Thank you.
You asked me that. Okay. Okay. I wouldn't approve it either.
One moment, Mr. Jackson.
No, I guess it's dead. So I want to expound.
All right. The motion on the table is for approval. All in favor of that motion, signify by raising your hand.
In favor, Rose, Dixon, Jackson, Pierce, Rush, Livingston, Dickerson, Manning, Jeter.
Any opposed? Like sign. That motion carries. Next, 88D.
You better not use that
motion. One moment. Come on. Let's get through this. 88D.
Oh.
Chairman, for 88E, I move that we approve the new positions for the Sheriff's Department, the new positions for facilities and grounds, and 3 of the 6 requested by the court administration.
Second.
That's the motion on the table. It's been properly second. Any discussion? Mr. Malinowski.
Yeah, we've got in here under operating office supplies for the new employees. Then you've got another section with another $6,000 for office supplies. What were those for? The new employees already are getting dollar amounts for office supplies. So I'm just wondering why we're putting more office supplies in. Aren't they bringing them from the old building to the new one? Nobody has an answer. So go ahead and take your vote.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Jackson. All right.
I'll make a substitute motion that we move that was requested. To fully staff the building.
That's the substitute motion.
What was that? That was requested to fully staff the center. That's my motion.
No. All right.
I'll second for discussion.
It's been properly seconded. Any more discussion?
Well, discussion.
No discussion. Any more discussion?
I think when the center was designed, we have certain offices. Court is a larger building, and you need more people in the building. So the consultants or whoever decided that this is what they need to be for safety and to run the building efficiently, I think I would support it. I wouldn't like to see we are short and we open the building and then we have to turn around and do a budget amendment or try and find another way to fund these other positions. If that's what the design was for and that's what it requires, because usually each facility
I required X amount of people for each department. They came up with a total number. They came up with what they need. I find it hard for me to decide that I know that's what you need, but I'm going to cut it because I just don't think you should have it. Thank you.
Shift working on.
All right, thank you, Mr. Jackson. Any more discussion? All in favor of the substitute motion, which is to approve all the positions?
I do have a question.
Mr. Malinowski.
Are there 8 new employees or 6?
Operating, we're giving office supplies to 4 new employees, then we're giving more office supplies to 4 new employees. That makes 8. So are there 8 or 6 employees? I just wonder how 8 new employees are getting office supplies if there's only 6.
Where are you reading that, Mr. Malinowski?
Under court administration, operating. Hold it, I'll tell you. Yeah, under operating, third one down, says office supplies, new employees.
All right, you're right.
4.
I see it twice.
And then 2 more down, says new. So I don't know if that's just a mistake and a repeat.
6. It's 6.
So should that total figure be 6 then?
Yes.
All right, thank you.
You want to adjust it, amend it?
Okay. any more discussion? All in favor of that item, signify by raising your hand.
Substitute motion.
The substitute motion.
Give them what they want?
Yes.
In favor, Rose, Dixon, Jackson, Jeter, and Rush.
All opposed, like sign?
Opposed, Malinowski, Pierce, Livingston, Dickerson, Manning.
Fails. That motion fails. The original motion is to approve without 3 of those?
Yep.
All in favor of that motion, signify by raising your hand.
In favor, Rose, Pierce, Rush, Livingston, Dickerson, Manning, Jeter.
All opposed, like sign?
Opposed, Malinowski, Jackson.
That motion carries. Item 88F.
Yep, Mr. Chairman, 88F is a reference to an issue I believe Mr. Pierce brought up just a few minutes ago with respect to the local government fund. If you've received or have reviewed the information that has gone out over the last few days, there was some additional monies placed in the local government fund by the state legislature. And when distributed to the counties, that gave Richland about $733,000 in additional money coming from that additional appropriation of the local government fund. And Mr. Pierce made a motion just a couple of minutes ago, which was approved, to use $218,000 of that to fund the bond court, the 24-hour bond court for next fiscal year. So that having been done, then this would change this. Well, not a motion because it's coming from administration, but this recommendation that the remainder of the local government fund, additional local government fund money, be used to offset the appropriation of fund balance that's already in the budget. So that would help lighten the load on the fund balance use, which would be now, I guess, somewhere in the area of about $500,000.
Okay.
That's right.
That motion for approval has been properly second. Discussion, Mr. Jeter.
Yes, I would like to do a substitute motion that we take $25,000 of that fund balance for the Antioch Church Senior Center. We've been funding them for the past 3 years. Somehow that motion didn't make it on the list, so I would like to take $25,000.
Think of that too.
$25,000 is one-time funding.
Second. That motion has been properly second. Any discussion?
Mr. Chair, I just want to ask him a question.
Ms. Dickerson.
Don't we fund them every year?
Yeah, it's the senior center.
Yeah.
So this is an annual thing that we do.
Well, we have to appropriate funding every year. They don't automatically get it. I mean, we have to vote against it.
Okay, so since we got the $500,000, you want $25,000
there.
All right,
Any more discussion? It's been properly seconded. Any more discussion? All in favor of that motion signify by raising your hand.
In favor of Dixon, Jackson, Rush, Livingston, Dickerson, Manning, Jeter.
All opposed, like sign.
Opposed, Rose, Malinowski, Pierce.
That motion carries. All right. Chairman, item 90.
I'd like to make a non-substitute motion.
Oh, no.
We're still on 89,
right?
That was just substitute motion.
Yeah, it's to approve the fund balance. It was to approve that amount minus the $25,000. Was that?
That was exactly the substitute was just $25,000 to go for that.
I thought it was both.
That's not what was said.
What was the clerk? What was the motion?
The motion was to fund $25,000 for the Antioch Senior Center.
All right, so we need a motion to approve the.
Okay, Mr. Manning.
I'd like to make a motion that with some of that additional local government fund that we received, that we fund for the solicitor's office a senior application support analyst. 69,352. A body cam video specialist at 69,352. And tier marks for personnel funds needed to implement the tiers that we passed on a reclassification plan in 2012.
Second.
Okay, that's the motion. It's been properly seconded. Discussion, Mr. Pierce.
Respectfully, I respect what you're trying to do, but this is this was non-recurring money. This was a one-time allocation. This wasn't an addition to the local government fund. It was simply one-time money. So all you've done, you've now funded positions, if it passes, that won't be funded next year. So I can't support the motion.
Mr. Jackson.
The positions are needed. I guess if we fund it now, we can find a way next year to fund it from somewhere else. But the positions are needed. We can't just say because we don't have a full set of funding to fund it for forever that we can't fund it now. We have to wait till next year. The positions are needed. If the sheriff department have these body cam, we need these technicians to do their job. What will we do? Come back for a budget amendment? I mean, we have to have it. Thank you.
Mr. Chairman, can I amend my motion?
Yes, sir.
Because I know we just did that for the bond court, and we didn't make an argument about that being one-time money. And now we're making that argument. But let me suggest then that the two positions be funded as grant, a one-year grant. And I'll take out about the 14,222 for the personnel fund. So that we would allocate 69,352 for the senior application support analyst and the body cam video specialist on each of those on a one-year contract.
How much does that come to?
Okay, do you accept that friendly amendment?
Yeah, I'll accept it.
Okay. Discussion, Mr. One moment, I'll get to you, Mr. Dixon. Mr. Malinowski.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. This council has not funded anything or approved body cameras at this point in time, so I don't know why you would need a body camera technician either. So if you take that one out.
We have Mr. Bronson address that, please.
Mr. Malinowski, in speaking with the solicitor's office, they are currently reviewing body camera footage because Richland County is not the only law enforcement agency the solicitor's office is responsible for in Richland County. They also have to
that's the thing about
represent the State Highway Patrol. City of Columbia and several other agencies that they're responsible for, some of those which are now currently using body cameras.
I would say if Richland County is not using it, why should Richland County foot the bill for body camera review? It should be those other agencies that chip in.
All right. Give us money. Livingston and Dickerson.
I guess my main concern here is, if I recall, when we first presented the budget, it might have been, I forget the number of it, but Mr. McDonald, you remember the number of persons who were requesting new positions?
Throughout the entire budget, yeah. Mr. Closer? I don't remember, but there were 15 or 20 departments that had requested a new position. There were a lot.
It was about a total of how many positions?
Somewhere in that neighborhood.
I don't recall, but it was a lot. it was a lot.
And that's my concern, because I'm not the one who can bet and say which is best and worst for those. If you're going to appropriate any money to do positions, I'd rather the administrator take the money and come back with a recommendation for me to try to pick and choose what's best out of all those 100 positions.
All right. Any more discussion?
Yeah, I have my name now.
Dickerson.
No, not me.
Pierce.
All right. First of all, let's go back to the bond court. The bond court was an existing program that was in operation. So I take exception to the fact that we did it for the bond court, so we're doing it for these people. The other thing is that we have needs not only in the solicitor's office, but if you recall, I think some of you received information from the probate court, the needs of the probate court. And the solicitor and the public defender had needs as well. The other thing is, to me is more important, is the budget is predicated on a $1.5 million going into the fund balance. And so this $733,000 is not new money. I mean, it will offset what we take out of the fund balance. And the fund balance is already has issues with it. So. And again, funding recurring positions with one-time money is just not a good practice. I don't care whether you call it a grant or whatever. It's just not a good practice. So I appreciate the interest in trying to do these things, but this is not the way to do this.
Thank you, Mr. Pierce. Mr. Jackson.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. We fund the solicitor's office. Right now, I don't care if the state troopers or whoever use body cameras, that office has a responsibility to process those videos. And I wouldn't feel comfortable moving forward and saying, okay, there's no technician, but money has been spent for body cameras, but they have no one to process it. And this council, we can do it as a grant and figure out next year where the money comes from, but it's needed. So therefore, I can't sit down and or maybe we'll find some other way, maybe from the administrator has some funding somewhere else, we can fund it permanently. If not, then we do it the best way we can until we find a way. But I wouldn't like to leave that office not being funded for certain parts, for something as important. Everywhere we go, the state legislators, we decided that body cameras are necessary. Now, certain people have body cameras, but we're saying, okay, good, have the body camera, but guess what? We want fund to process it. So why have the body camera? It's just a waste.
Thank you. Thank you, Jackson. Mr. Rose.
This goes back to just a total disconnect between the legislature and the problems and troubles that local governments face.
Yeah.
There is a law that gets passed that says law enforcement must wear body cameras. And when these cases, if there's a murder or a big time crime scene, you have 30 different officers respond to the scene. By law, each one of them have to be wearing that body camera, and each one of them can have hours upon hours of footage. That has to be gone through. And again, our legislature passes this, and the buck gets passed to us on how to fund it. That's all I have to say.
Thank you, Mr. Rose. Any more discussion, Ms. Dickerson?
I hope I'm saying this right. And I hope nobody take offense to what I'm trying to say. But if if I have a relative that's in a position, am I supposed to recluse myself from discussion?
Hmm?
From voting.
Voting. Clarify.
I'm asking if a family member, say for instance when Mr. Livingston works at Midlands Tech, he recluses himself on certain votes. Is that not approved? Is that not the policy?
Yeah.
That's not the policy. I can't vote on Midlands Tech budget. I just choose not to, but you gave Gee's opinion
that you can. Mm-hmm. That's all I need to know.
Okay.
Thank you.
Any more discussion? Any more discussion?
That's not true.
You don't
work down on it? He does, but I can explain that if you want to explain it.
I
ain't going to do that.
Okay, any more discussion?
Just for clarification. What is it that Mr. Manning was saying to include?
That's what she's trying to do. On a contractual basis, which is very, very, very different than approving an ongoing regular personnel position. For a senior application support analyst and a body cam video specialist.
And you said that was how much?
$69,352 for each, for a total of just under $140,000.
Okay, that's a good
one
one
time because one-year contracts are one-time money.
Okay. Okay, you heard the motion that's on the floor.
What's that?
It's been properly seconded already. Okay. All in favor of that motion signify by raising your hand.
In favor, Rose, Dixon, Jackson, Dickerson, Manning, Jeter.
All opposed, like sign.
Opposed, Malinowski, Pierce, Rush, Livingston.
And motion carries. All right, now, where are we, Mr. McDonnell? 88F?
Mr. Chairman, 80, I think you just did 88F.
Okay, 89.
Yeah, 89.
Do we need to approve this less those amounts?
You need to approve this, but if you would approve it as amended, because practically everything in 89 changed tonight. Okay. So just if you would approve the total budget as amended, that would work.
So just 89.
So move, Mr. Chair.
Got a motion for approval. It's been properly seconded. Discussion. All in favor of that motion signify by raising your hand.
In favor, Dixon, Pierce, Jackson, Rush, Livingston, Dickerson, Jeter.
All opposed, like sign.
Opposed, Rose, Malinowski.
That motion carries. Item 90.
Item 90 is the budget ordinance.
You got a motion for approval. It's been properly. That motion for approval. Motion for approval.
Second.
It's been properly seconded. Discussion. All in favor of that motion signify by raising your hand.
In favor, Dixon, Jackson, Pierce, Rush, Livingston, Dickerson, Jeter.
All opposed, like sign.
Opposed, Rose Malinowski.
That motion carries. All right. So we don't need to do 91.
Mr. Chairman, item 91 is the millage ordinance. You would not approve that until September, October timeframe when the millage numbers are.
And that's when we do it then. Okay.
Different, yes.
So what else we have? 92?
93L. Mr. Chairman.
Michelle, please put Manning down for that last one.
This. Thank
you. Yeah. Go ahead, Mr. McDonald.
Mr. Chairman, 93L is the bond ordinance for the capital projects that you approved on second reading. That would need to be approved tonight for third reading.
Okay. Chair, entertain a motion. Motion for approval has been properly seconded.
Discussion. What?
Discussion.
What's that now?
Yes. Mr. Malinowski.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Item 93D, security improvements at the Judicial Center. Is that referring to the email that we got that said they wanted to fence in the courthouse and have 200 cameras placed for security purposes?
It is for security cameras and other security implementation
right.
items.
Right, and,
yes.
and the reason that email came, it referred to the fact that there were several homeless people there throughout the evening, and they were littering and urinating and doing whatever else on the property. Rather than approve this amount of money, this $355,000 for that, has anybody considered going to the Columbia Police Department and asking them if they could increase patrols, move the people along in
yes.
the evening?
Yes.
They have?
Yes. That has been an ongoing problem. I don't know that that's the reason for the security. The security request came from the clerk of court and was endorsed, strongly endorsed by the Sheriff's Department and I believe the Solicitor's Office, too, for the $355,000, which is security for the entire facility, not just external, but internal as well.
So we're not going to have 200 cameras rimming the outside of the building?
100?
Mr. Malinowski, I'm not...
I'd kind of like to see some additional information with this. You know, how much is it going to cost for fencing? Where is it going to be placed? Where
sure.
are these cameras going to be? Before we just arbitrarily create the Richland County compound in downtown Columbia.
I understand.
Thank you.
So, thank you, Mr. Malinowski. Mr. Jackson.
At this point,
thank
you. I mean, how do we...
I want to register I'm not in a position to tell the experts where to put the cameras, and I want to see detail how much cameras and where the cameras are supposed to be. If they send me a report that is needed for safety, I'm not jeopardizing the safety of any citizens because I want to detail where the cameras are supposed to be posed. And how many cameras? They're the expert. I'm not the expert. So who am I to tell you, well, you don't need a camera here, it's too much camera, right? I have to trust, at some time, I have to trust the experts in what they say and what they need. I'm not going to pick and nitpick and micromanage everything that comes before us. That's ridiculous. Thank you.
Mr. Pierce.
I'm not sure I want to say anything. No, I'm concerned about the fence, all right? Fencing in public property. What? I mean, we're going to put up a chain link fence around it. Could Major Cowan, do you know? I just want to know, it's a legitimate question to ask about the fence on public
Major
property.
Cowan, Richland County Sheriff's Department. We did a complete security assessment of the Judicial Center. There are specific security needs that are mandated and that are required and that are encouraged by the U.S. Marshals and all the experts nationally, as well as what we have at the department. There are several components to that security. Some of them are cameras. Some of them are fencing in certain areas.
Okay.
Some of them are to restrict access. Some of them are magnetometers. There's different components to this that are an all-inclusive security package. It's not just one item.
That's all I needed to hear. The way the email was written, it implied that we were going to have a massive fence around the building. And I just couldn't believe that you would do that. Mm-hmm. And that's all I need to know. I'm good.
Thank you.
All right, Mr. Malinowski.
And that's all I wanted to know also, to hear something that confirmed this need, because as Mr. Pierce says, the email was written to make it look like we were going to have this horrendous building down there with fencing and all. And I'm not nitpicking or questioning it. I just wanted the additional information to confirm that from our experts. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Y'all don't want to.
That's all clarification. I'm not fussing.
All right. You are. Go ahead.
Do we have fence in this building at the back? Is there a fence at the back?
A fence?
Yes.
On this building?
I mean, on the, with the ambulance and all.
There's a fence around the parking
Okay,
lot.
Thank you very yes, much. Public property, we have a fence. Thank you.
All right. All in favor of that? The motion is for approval?
Yeah.
All in favor of that motion, signify by raising your hand.
In favor, Rose, Dixon, Jackson, Malinowski, Rush, Livingston, Dickerson, Manny, Jeter.
All opposed, like sign. That motion carries.
Move approval of the bond ordinance.
Second.
Motion for approval has been properly second. Discussion. Broad River.
The whole bond, the remaining bond.
No, wait a minute. This is Broad River.
Isn't
you doing
right?
94 and 95 or?
Yep, that's it. Yep.
You want to do 94 and 95 or just 94?
Here's the other one.
Both them all.
Is that good? 94 and 95?
Absolutely.
Okay, I got a motion for approval of both 94
both
and 95.
94 and 95.
It's been properly second. Any discussion? All in favor of that motion, signify by raising your hand.
In favor, Rose, Dixon, Jackson, Pierce, Rush, Livingston, Dickerson, Manning, Jeter.
Any opposed? Like sign?
Opposed, Malinowski.
That motion carries.
Mr. Chairman.
Yep. Hold on for a second. 1 second.
I was just going to clarify number 95, Mr. Chairman. That was
to clinch.
To clinch, yes. So you need to make a motion to reconsider.
That's what I thought.
Before we move forward,
95.
I want to ask about item number 54 because it seems to be an error. That was the administrator's recommendation. It has Mr. Manning, and that was for operations for Pamela Lake Park. Did we discuss that?
That was withdrawn. That was withdrawn. No.
It was lump sum.
Withdrawn.
I didn't withdraw it. Mr. Manning, did you withdraw it?
Manning.
Yeah. Yeah, Mr. If you're talking about the 150 for the operations,
yeah.
It was actually in the recommended hospitality tax budget. I think that may be why Mr. Manning's additional 150
was. So we got to clinch it. You got a motion for reconsideration?
Second.
Correct.
It's been properly, motion reconsideration has been properly seconded. Any discussion? All in favor signify by raising your hand.
Just move.
Reconsideration. No, it's a name.
Okay. All in favor?
Malinowski.
Any opposed?
Opposed, Dixon, Jackson, Pierce, Rush, Livingston, Dickerson, Manning, Jeter.
That motion carries. I mean, that motion fails.
Clarification. What does this mean?
We're done.
When they clinch it, what does it mean?
That is,
they
can move forward.
I mean, you can't make any changes?
Not now.
I just want a clarification.
Yeah, that's what it means.
What does it mean when you clean something? Mr. Administrator,
what does that mean?
I just want to be clear.
Yes, sir. Mr. Jackson, Mr. Chairman, when you clinch the vote, that has the same effect as approving the minutes of the meeting at the next council meeting. It just does it.
We can't just go back and change anything.
More quickly. That's correct. You could rescind it and bring up another motion, but you could not reconsider because you've already done that.
Thank you very much. I just want to...
Okay, Chair,
point of personal privilege before we go. I just want to say, you know, we've had a little rough year in the press, but I just want to say that I think that this county's council, and I think the staff of this county, have done an absolutely wonderful job preparing a huge budget to cover the needs of the citizens of Richland County. And, you know, we had all the trees we were dealing with, but on the forest, I think that this group and this staff did a wonderful job for the citizens of Richland County. And I just want to say that.
Thank you, Mr. Manning. Thank you for that, Mr. Manning.
And Mr. McDonald, this is your last budget.
Chair entertain.
Yes, ma'am, Mr.
Chair entertain the motion for adjournment.
Move adjourned, Mr. Chairman.
It's been properly seconded. Any discussion? All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? We're adjourned.